Afare, and welcome to the first broadcast of the Learn Chamorro podcast with my co-host, Dr. Mike Lujan Bevacqua.
Mm-hmm. Hello, Afare.
Hey, hello. To all the listeners out there, well, we like to share with you how excited we are to start this podcast for LearnChamorro.com. What you find in the future is Mike and Dr. Mike. How do you like to be addressed, Mike? Dr. Bevacqua, Mike.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter to me.
It doesn't matter to you. Okay. Mike sounds more personal.
Sure. And,
more okay.
Sure.
Okay, Mike. So, again, for the listeners, we're excited to come together with Mike here, who is very knowledgeable with the language, the history, and the culture, which makes him a triple threat. You know, for knowledge. isn't that what they call it?
Sure.
A triple threat, like person who can sing, dance, and am I right?
I wouldn't mind doing all those things.
Yeah,
too.
Exactly. So the purpose of the podcast is to team up. I myself, I'm sure, like everybody that's listening to this podcast, will address issues. We cover many different topics, but the primary focus is to capture the market, which is myself, who may have who grew up learning the language by listening, but I didn't speak back. So we understand a very good amount of it just to get by, but we struggle to respond with the language itself. And so I am stepping up, you know, with my efforts with my family and my kids to make it a point to practice every day, to learn something every day, and use it every day, at least once, you know what I mean? And even if it's a repetitive, redundant, one sentence type of exercise, the point is that we use it every day and we say it out loud so that we can be comfortable and we can learn as we go. What do you think, Mike? You think that's a good...
That's wonderful. You know, we're at a very, very important point for the Chamorro language right now because... expensive. Because right now we have still a lot of speakers. You know, you can go around to churches, to parties, to homes, and you can still hear quite a few people that are speaking the Chamorro language. But within a generation, that's going to change.
Absolutely.
Because that oldest generation, they didn't really teach it to their children. And they certainly didn't teach it to their grandchildren.
Yep.
And so most languages survive because they get passed on naturally.
That's right.
Because those who speak it feel like, I got to speak it to my kids, I'm going to speak it to my kids. Now, for Chamorros, that got interrupted after World War II. And so it means then that the language will survive because people such as you and me and anyone else, we make a decision where we want to learn the Chamorro language,
right.
And we are going to help keep it alive.
That's right.
And it would be so much easier if those who are older just decided, you know what, I'm going to speak to my kids in Chamorro and they're going to learn this language. They can learn English along the way too,
sure.
I'm going to make sure they learn Chamorro. But unfortunately, we don't have a lot of people out there that have made that decision. So we got to learn as adults.
That's right.
And it's a little bit more difficult, but
you got to start sometime.
If you push through it, if you keep trying, you put your heart into it, your soul,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah. It's a real desire to.
Think of it as like a Chamorro labor of love.
Correct.
And so if you do that, you can play a very big role in keeping the language alive.
Now, Mike, let me interrupt you real quick and switch gears real quick. And I'd like to share with the folks out there. And I hope you don't mind me sharing this with the audience. But I'm very proud, man, to partner with you. And one of the key reasons why as well, not because of your triple threat knowledge, but because that you are the poster child, man, of a family. The epitome of what needs to happen with your kids. And, you know, not too many people may not know this, but Mike has a couple of kids.
Two kids.
And the kids' names are?
Sumahi is my older daughter, 7 years old, and then Akli'i, who's 4 years old.
And correct me if I'm wrong, I mean, I know you told me this before, but for the audience, your kids speak fluent Chamorro. Well, not fluent, I mean, yes, fluent, but I mean, you know, they...
Well, I wish that... I wish that it were that easy. Now, for me, I didn't grow up speaking Chamorro at all.
Yes, there you go. Thank you.
And so when I learned it as an adult, you know, I realized that if the language is going to survive, people really have to make choices in their lives. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it might be a little bit more difficult because learning a language as an adult in many ways, it's a humbling experience. You got to start back over.
Yeah.
And it's different if, you know, if you want to learn like Klingon or something just for kicks, that's one thing. But if you want to learn a language which has been in your people's lives for thousands of years,
yes,
and you don't speak it already, it can be difficult because,
yes,
you feel like,
of course,
you know, I'm Chamorro, I should have some genetic advantage at, mm-hmm, learning this language. But,
yeah,
what you find is that you don't really have a genetic language. It's hard to learn a language as an adult.
Sure.
And so, you know, for me, I learned as an adult, and I decided, and I was like, you know what, when I have kids, I'm only going to speak to them in Chamorro.
Nice.
And so,
wow.
And so since the day my kids were born, that's all I speak to them.
Very nice, Nick.
Obviously, I use some English words,
sure,
every once in a while, but for the most part, everything happens in Chamorro. And my daughter, you know, my daughter is fluent. My daughter can speak back, and she can tell stories.
Very nice.
And for her, it's not a problem. But she also learned English along the way, you,
yes,
know. No problem there. And my son is a little bit more resistant. He's, he doesn't want to.
He'll get it wrong.
Boys develop slower.
Yes.
I've really learned that really women should rule the world.
Women.
Women are just much more intelligent.
Mike's on the record.
Faster than men are.
Hey, your co-host is a man, dude. Hello.
I know, we're both men.
No, man. Thank you, man, for sharing that, man, Mike. And you know, and the reason why I mentioned this, Jello, is because, you know, I want to encourage, not give encourage, but to give hope to the listeners as this audience grows. And I assure you, man, with the help of the Mariners Variety newspaper, man, God bless Tom over there and his excitement and enthusiasm for podcast shows. You know, by the way, this is the first announcement publicly, you know, that mm-hmm, our partnership with the Variety. And so, you know, with his help, you know, to perpetuate this program and to promote it, hopefully we can get a strong following. And we want to invite the listeners of the show. Mike and I are committed. Today is our first day together, and we are committed to have this once a week. Is that right, Mike?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Once a week, no excuses. We're going to do what it takes to make sure we have content on the show. What we'll do in the future is we'll talk about some language history, and then, you know, for the most part, you know, what I will be doing in the next few days, in the next week. I already have it set up, but I want to have it in a way where you guys can call a number or even get on the internet and actually record your voice to be a part of the show.
Mm.
It's going to take a little bit of work, but I've done my homework and I've exercised it, and it'll be very easy. We can take questions, you know, from the audience as we move forward. So it'll be like a talk show host, if you will, you know, a talk radio.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. And so, And the reason why this makes a perfect combination for Mike and I is because my passion for creating these products, like with my DVD and the website itself, you know, it's my life's work and my absolute passion to stick with it and to build on it and to build content and to provide it for free, you know, for everyone to learn, you know, because one of the things that I've noticed when I came back from being away for so long was that the lack or complete absence of, you know, simple, friendly, multimedia, simple conversational phrases and learning vocabulary exercises and whatnot. And, you know, nowadays the kids, man, Mike, I mean, come on now, you know, the,
yep,
phones and, you know, internet, you know what I mean?
Yep.
You give them paper and reading, you know, they completely ignore it, but you get them on that computer and whoo, all you gotta do is press a button, you can hear how it sounds, you can take a picture and slide it across the monitor of the phone to match the, you know, so we'll be building a lot of games as we go. So I don't want to give too much away, but, you know, just that was a little insight of what's to come. Mike, again, he's a professor at the University of Guam.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Chamorro Studies, is that correct?
Yes.
Can you expand on that? And what's your
resume? I have my educational background is I went to college here at University of Guam. I got a master's degree in Micronesian studies. And then I left Ireland and got a PhD in ethnic studies, and then I came back and I've been teaching at the university ever since. And so with the help of others at UOG, we created the first ever Chamorro Studies program.
Very nice.
And so students can go to the University of Guam and they can major or double major in Chamorro Studies. And this program is a great opportunity for any student, because many students come to UOG hoping to learn some Chamorro,
mm-hmm,
and be fluent in it. But in order to graduate, you just have to take two language classes.
Okay.
And two language classes of any two classes of any language doesn't really make you fluent.
Of course.
But through the Chamorro Studies program, we now have 6 Chamorro language classes.
Very nice.
2 beginners, 2 intermediate, and 2 advanced.
Very nice.
And so those who go through our program, by the end of it, you should be reading and writing in Chamorro.
You should be speaking,
conversing, storytelling. You have to be, your final, basically before you graduate, you got to give a public presentation in the Chamorro language.
Oh, man. Has there been a graduation yet of this one?
No, we've had some minors graduate. Minors, you don't have to take as many classes.
Sure.
Because the program just started last year.
Okay. Yeah. That's exciting.
We have a strong group of majors, and we're always looking for more. And so the great thing about Chamorro Studies is that if you're going to go into something more traditional, mm-hmm. you can always get Chamorro Studies as a double major.
Oh, okay.
So if you're going to, so some of our best students are social work majors mm-hmm. who also are getting a Chamorro Studies degree.
Okay.
Because they feel like
sure.
the Chamorro Studies degree will help them with their social work.
Absolutely.
Or history majors and Chamorro Studies majors.
Yeah. Oh, thank you for mentioning that, buddy. One of the things that I myself personally, I mean, extremely, extremely excited, man, to be working with you, Mike, is the history part.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm gonna put myself out there, man. You know, I'm somewhat ashamed a little bit, that, you know, I don't know too much about my culture's history, man.
Mm.
I mean, you know, let's be honest here. I mean, most of us don't, you know, and mm-hmm. this is another, this is another great opportunity for, you know, not to get a complete history, you know, but as we move on with the different podcast shows in the weeks to come, you know, I'm definitely going to be highlighting some suggested topics to talk about with you.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
You know, I mean, you yourself, I mean, oh, I'm sure you can just get into it so much, you know.
Oh, yeah. The language, and if you're interested in Chamorro history,
mm-hmm.
the language is a very interesting view. It can give you a very interesting image into Chamorro history.
Nice.
Because what we take just as simple words contain all sorts of things about the philosophy of the Chamorro people, their beliefs,
uh-huh.
And sort of not just their history in terms of how other languages have come and shaped it, but basically it really contains like ghosts, if you want to think about
uh-huh.
it, like fingerprints from the way that they have lived their lives over thousands of years
and changed.
And so the language is, you know, I definitely think that getting into history is so important, but one of the really good ways to open up the past mm-hmm. is really to learn the language too.
Yes, absolutely.
To learn the language too. I mean,
like I said, triple threat, baby. You know what I'm saying? I mean, imagine the difficulty of having, you know, getting an expert in the language, right? Yeah, I mean, you know, we can find a few of them out here. But history? Come on, man. I think I've lucked out in getting a great co-host partner here.
Hey, Buster.
Hey, come on, Philo. Come on, be honest. So, again, this is the first podcast introduction as far as what's to come. Again, I want to reiterate and remind the folks that I myself, the publisher of the LearnChamorro.com, is a product of the demographics of people that grew up, you know, listening to the Chamorro language, hearing it, maybe and just answering back their parents or grandparents in English. You know, but we understand it, you know, for the most part. You know, we struggle to respond back, if not at all. And so I am committed, man, to give myself 1 year, man.
Mike, mm-hmm.
1 year with honest, true dedication, with the spirit behind it, to really want to learn with my kids, you know. And, you know, bro, I was thinking about having another podcast, just a separating of recordings from me and my kids.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, I'm not too sure how, you know, that's, you know, but I was thinking, imagine how it would be awesome would it be if we started out with videotaping, because my kids love the phone, right?
Mm-hmm.
So imagine if we got the phone and we videotape ourselves, just real, like maybe 30-second clips, you know, of me talking to them, you know, time to go fix their room or, you know, brush their teeth,
mm-hmm.
you know, come and eat, you know, things around the house that you say every day over and over and over. You know, if we start from that, you know, again, I'm not sure, you know, exactly how to do it, but I just want to get started and do it. And so what we'll have on the podcast below on the section, I'll have some show notes, just quick brief one-liners of what topics we covered, and what we'll also like to cover Mike is to have some structured educational, you know, words and sentences or vocabulary, you know,
mm-hmm.
and I have some suggested formats, and then Mike and I will of course fine-tune that, and of course this program is gonna evolve and change until we get to a place where we feel that it's comfortable and, you know, keep it permanent and the same, if you will, so people can know exactly what to expect. So how does that sound, Mike?
Yeah, sounds good.
Okay, is there anything else, buddy, you'd like to add to our audience, and maybe your thoughts on the future of the podcast, and your excitement, and maybe on what could come and evolve to fruition with this?
Well, I mean, for me, I find it very sad that within a generation or two, we could lose
absolutely
more language.
Absolutely,
I find that to be very sad.
15 years, man. 20 years. What do you think?
Within learning to speak Chamorro was sort of one of my favorite sort of experiences in my entire life.
I can tell, man. Yeah.
And so
articles.
For me, looking back, it's kind of like, preventing the loss of our language is a very serious thing.
Absolutely,
for me.
Man. Absolutely.
And so any way that I can help people learn, encourage people, promote the language and just get people to sort of get past the mental blocks that they have.
There you go. Thank
or
you.
Sort of get past the the logistical blocks
and
that
the
they
fear,
have.
The...
Anything that I can offer to sort of help that, I'm down. And so that's why I'm glad to help learnchamorro.com, because you have a really good intent. You have a really good sort
Thank
of
you, man. Mike, bless
a
you.
Message to just learn the language, just use it, just get it out there.
Get it out there, exactly.
Make it available.
Make it available and get it out there.
Yeah. And I love that. And so that's why, I'm glad to be on the podcast, and I'm glad to be working with you, Troy.
Wow, chalo, man. You just mastered that, my brother. One of the things also too, as suggested, I suggested with Mike, and he agrees that I have some translations that I have with me on the next podcast. I'll start to use them in conjunction with the podcast on a regular basis, so I can practice myself, and to say it to you. And then, to show the people, the followers of the podcast, and watch me grow. How awesome would it be? Here I am. Look, right now, it's mostly I'm speaking English, And so as I get the translations and I, learn them and I use them on the podcast, And of course, we will guide the listeners to what Mike says in Chamorro or what I would say in Chamorro, so they can learn and hear it. Mm-hmm. And one thing that was absent, man, for the longest time, of course, in anything out there, just like the Chamorro and the PDN, and all those great resources out there, is the audio. Mm-hmm. And so this hopefully is the last mile for solving that issue of how to say things and pronounce things, mm-hmm. And so I believe with all my heart, again, why do I know this for a fact? Because I am that product of mm-hmm. that mm-hmm. deficiency. Mm-hmm. So I know what I'm talking about. I know the reason why I know is because I'm that person. And I know there are thousands and thousands and thousands of people like myself. And I tell you right now, guys, this show is going to be raw and honest and from the heart. Don't be offended if I say something off the cuff or what, but my friend told me something. I wear my heart on my sleeve. I'm not sure what that means, but I just say what my heart tells me to say. I'm not going to be disrespectful, but I'm going to tell you from my point of view and my honesty of what I am. And I'll tell you, that I'm scared. I'm nervous right now, but guess what? If I'm excited to learn, and I'm excited to impact the others out there who are just like me, and I know for a fact there are thousands of them. And stop pretending you don't know. Stop pretending like you know what people are saying. Ask questions. Don't just be quiet. And if someone's talking to you, don't be ashamed to say, "Man, dispensala, uncle, auntie. What did you say? Mm-hmm. Do not be afraid, man. How can you learn if you don't? And guess what? If you do that and you show them an actual interest, they're gonna want to talk to you more and more. And help you along the way. And I apologize for those out there. Here it goes, right here. For those of you who like to tease or ridicule others about how they sound, please do not do that. You have no idea the kind of damage you're doing to the people who want to learn. Because just that one comment of ridicule, that one humorous chuckle of how they're saying it, could completely destroy their interest and their spirit for learning more. So please, for guys who think it's funny. Yeah, it may be funny, and I agree. It could be, it's funny, but because of the sensitivity of the reality of what's in the people's heart, and that's me, so I know exactly what I'm talking about. Please don't do that, and let's support each other and keep this podcast and comments on a very positive, supportive tone. How's that sound, Mike?
Malik,
Zahwana. Okay, chalo. So everyone, we'd like to say thank you for listening to the show. Mike, any closing comments before we leave?
No, I just look forward to talking to everyone, and I hope that over the course of these podcasts, we can educate some people and push people forward in their learning of the Chamorro language.
Okay, now we have to leave with something in Chamorro. So Mike, can you please tell something to the people from your heart, from, you know, as far as in Chamorro, what you'd like to say? Something in real brief, you know, thank them or something of that nature. Oh. What would you like to say?
Oh.
And of course, shortly after you do that, explain in English what you said.
Oh, okay. Well, both Magufu and I, nagagidugwini na, you know, kumitapagutroy na yun at naputfin na yun at tatsotsubiesti. Gof malagasti na oportunidad para tanahudzong tagwini na yung i-information sa nitiningo na kuri lingwahito. And so I'm so happy to be here, you know, with you, Troy.
Yes, sir.
This is a wonderful opportunity for us to really put the knowledge, you know, and information about the language out there for
Absolutely.
People.
And you know what? I tell you right now, I translate that. I receive when I heard you say that, I knew what you said, but not in the exact form. But I knew what you're saying. Mm. And so I'm comfortable. I feel good now because, you know, as we move forward again. You're going to teach us the words and how to put them together. Mm. And when we get to that part about how to connect the sentences together and how we have all these pronouns and mm-hmm. adverbs or preposition phrases or whatever, you know, mm-hmm. you know, it's going to be great. So, okay, shalom.
Si Jesus basta talo. Hago lo ku esta.